Palmer Tom's Dogs 247 Sports, Georgia football, of course, they'll be in the mix for an SEC championship and probably more because, my goodness, this roster is stacked. And they look at the running back room, and it's just more of the same, what we see every year. But I'm seeing names in Zamir White, Kenny McIntosh, James Cook on down the line that are not only super talented, but they've been on campus, been in the system for now an extended period of time. So they could really flourish here after having some decent seasons this past year.
Yeah, I mean, you look at this past season, Zamir White and James Cook were, and Kenny McIntosh, for a matter of fact, too, they were really stepping into bigger roles, taking over, you know, and filling the shoes of DeAndre Swift and Brian Herrien, two guys that, you know, kind of handled the running back duties for Georgia the last couple of seasons leading up to 2020. And, you know, White, obviously, incredibly talented, number one running back in his class when he signed in 2018. James Cook was a top five running back in that class, too. And both of them kind of started off their college careers slowly. You know, obviously with White, he tore his ACL his freshman season, missed all of that, and then, you know, was behind several talented backs in 2019. James Cook was kind of used as more of a utility guy, you know, had big numbers receiving, big numbers rushing, you know, and it was kind of a game for these Georgia offensive coordinators of the last couple of seasons to figure out how they were going to use James Cook. You know, you look back at the 2018 season with Jim Chaney as the offensive coordinator. Cook was a freshman. He got utilized a little bit, but not nearly as much as he has under Todd Monken this past season. Same thing with James Coley in 2019. You know, there was a lot of talk that they were going to use the backs out of the backfield a lot more often in the passing game, and it didn't really transpire that way. So, you know, I think you look at James Cook and the way the production that he had this past season, you know, had 303 yards rushing and also put up some big numbers in the passing game, finishing with 225 yards there. Had a 100-yard game against Alabama in the receiving game. Had another 100-yard game. Believe it was against Kentucky rushing. But I would have to go back and check on that one. So, you know, he got a lot more comfortable under Todd Monken as the offensive coordinator. And then, like you mentioned, down on the line, Kenny McIntosh, Dejon Edwards, Kendall Milton. You know, there's a lot of talent there. And you bring in another talented guy out of IMG, Lavoisier Carroll. You know, the guy that I would watch would be Kendall Milton. He was a true freshman this past year, got banged up towards the end of the season against Florida and missed some time, ended up returning for the bowl game. But, you know, obviously was not 100%. He's a guy that reminds me a lot of, you know, maybe Nick Chubb, you know, looking back at some of these Georgia running backs of the past. You know, he runs really, really hard. And another guy that runs really, really hard is Dejon Edwards, who was also a true freshman this past year. Got some carries in some of the later games, you know, looking back at the South Carolina and the Missouri games where Georgia, you know, handedly won those. You know, he got some carries, especially with Milton banged up, and they didn't really want to give a ton of, you know, a ton of reps to their top guys in White, Cook, and McIntosh. You know, he's a guy that I would watch. And then, you know, I bring up McIntosh there. He really did it all for Georgia. You know, he had some big returns in the return game, you know, showed some ability that he could break some runs. He's another guy that I would watch, you know, that could have a breakout season in his third year with the program. You know, I guess the overall narrative for this running back room would be, like you said, they're talented, they're experienced, and they're dynamic.
Zamir White definitely leads the pack, at least based on what happened last year with 11 touchdowns, 800 yards practically on the ground. And the other guys had not a whole lot of wear and tear between Milton, Cook, and McIntosh, between 35 and 47 carries. So they've got a lot of tread on the tires to go, no question about that. I will say the one thing, Palmer, that stands out to me in comparison to these guys statistically compared to all the great line of running backs that we've had in this system, especially since about 2011, 2012, would be their yards per carry. They're good. They're good yards per carry. If you pull that up, that stat sheet up for just about any team in America, at most of those guys at about 5.5 yards per carry. But the Sony Michels and DeAndre Swifts of the world and Nick Chubb and on down the line, man, we saw 7.5 yards per carry. And just, I think that's got to be the combination of obviously their skill and ability being even at another level possibly, and also their ability to read blocks and pick the right holes and do all those things, but also the offensive line. And we'll get into the guys up front here and how the offensive line stacks up versus what we've seen in recent years.
Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, you look at, you know, the like you said, the yards per carry weren't great for those running backs, and I think that was really hurt by two poor games against Cincinnati and Mississippi State. You know, coincidentally, those were two of JT Daniels' bigger games, and Georgia was still able to win those, with Daniels throwing for 401 and 392 against Mississippi State and Cincinnati, respectively. But, you know, you look at the game, the performance of the running game, they had 8 yards against Mississippi State and just 45 against Cincinnati. Obviously, that factors in sacks as well. You know, Daniels lost 20 yards on sacks in the bowl game. But, you know, those were not great performances. And I, like you said, I think that that was, you know, indicative of, you know, maybe some poor play of the offensive line in those games.